Bonjour, I bet many of you are relying on the French you learned at school to understand spoken French. Well, I'm very sorry to say, but that's a mistake. N'aimes-tu pas la tarte aux pommes? Do you understand this? Well, that's good, but the problem is that no French person would ever, ever say this. Let's listen to the same phrase again. N'aimes-tu pas la tarte aux pommes? Should be, t'aimes pas la tarte aux pommes? That's a big difference, right? Sadly, school French is way too academic for real life. Today, I'm going to show you uniquely spoken French grammar rules that you can memorize. I'm Géraldine, c'est parti! Listen to this description of Normandy. La Normandie est une région au nord-ouest de la France, au bord de la Manche. On peut y manger des huîtres ou visiter les stations balnéaires comme Deauville, Honfleur et bien d'autres. Il n'y a pas que du littoral. La Normandie a aussi un terroir incroyable, avec des bons fromages comme le camembert et des pommes pour le cidre. Et si tu n'aimes pas le cidre, tu peux essayer le calvados. Il y a également les plages du débarquement, bien sûr, ou le jardin de Monet à Giverny. Et le Mont Saint-Michel surtout, un site incontournable. So, this is a simple text in slow and correct French. We'll get to the everyday French version of it in a bit. But first, I want to stop on one very important French word. It is le terroir. Repeat after me. Le terroir. Le terroir. Again, le terroir. Le terroir is a combination of a good land, local farmers and traditional know-how that turn into fantastic products. I will talk about le terroir in more detail in the blog post about the lesson. You will find the link below in the description on YouTube. Now, before diving into informal French, let's listen at the text again with the translation a little bit faster. What can you understand? La Normandie est une région au nord-ouest de la France, au bord de la Manche. On peut y manger des huîtres ou visiter les stations balnéaires comme Deauville, Honfleur et bien d'autres. Il n'y a pas que du littoral. La Normandie a aussi un terroir incroyable, avec des bons fromages comme le camembert et des pommes pour le cidre. Et si tu n'aimes pas le cidre, tu peux essayer le calvados. Il y a également les plages du débarquement, bien sûr, ou le jardin de Monet à Giverny, et le Mont Saint-Michel surtout, un site incontournable. Did you understand everything now? The problem is that in real life, French people don't speak so correctly. We tend to use informal grammar. One common trick that we have is to use la répétition. La répétition. Repetition a lot, really, a lot, everywhere. By la répétition, here I mean that we use two subjects in the same sentence. For example, instead of saying la Normandie est, Normandy is, la Normandie est, or en Normandie les gens ont, in Normandy people have, en Normandie les gens ont, we will say la Normandie c'est, Normandy it is, or la Normandie ils ont, Normandy they have. This is incorrect French, but it is the grammar that we are going to use when we are actually speaking. In informal French, we also use tu most of the time for the informal you. We will also use filler words in the middle of sentences. For example, tu vois for you see in English. Tu vois. And of course, we saw that many times before, we drop the ne in negations and we don't do the inversion of the verb in the subject in questions. In other words, we're going to say t'aimes pas le cidre? You don't like cider? T'aimes pas le cidre? Repeat after me. T'aimes pas le cidre? Instead of si tu n'aimes pas le cidre, if you don't like cider, si tu n'aimes pas le cidre, or even more formal, n'aimes-tu pas le cidre? Don't you like cider? Which is what we should say, but no one ever uses that form. Then we also use informal expressions such as genre, instead of par exemple. We might also use et tout ça, with the silent T at the end of tout. Et tout ça, instead of et tout le reste, or et tout cela, or etc. that you might have learned at school. Then you also have après, y'a aussi, après, y'a aussi, for cela dit, il y a aussi. Because as you might know, the impersonal il often disappears. So we say après, y'a aussi. Après, y'a aussi, which means then you also have. In the informal version of today's text, for instance, you're going to find faut pas croire que y'a que. Ooh, this is really spoken French. Faut pas croire que y'a que. Here, the il and the ne disappeared as well. Did you notice? Faut pas croire que y'a que. We should say il ne faut pas croire qu'il n'y a que. We shouldn't believe that there is only. Il ne faut pas croire qu'il n'y a que. But no one ever says that. As you can see, the correct version of the sentence would take much more time, and this is unacceptable for a fast French speaker. Finally, sometimes grammar mistakes are just that, mistakes. And it is not uncommon to hear il faut que tu le voies. It hurts me to show you that, but it is true, some people say that. Il faut que tu le voies. You need to see it. Here the trick is that the subjunctive of the verb voir is wrong. We should not say voie. We should say il faut que tu le voies. Il faut que tu le voies. Or even better yet, tu dois le voir. You have to see it. Tu dois le voir. Okay, now you're ready. You have all the elements to try to understand my fast spoken French version of the text. Breathe in, breathe out, and c'est parti. La Normandie, c'est une région au nord-ouest de la France, au bord de la Manche. Tu peux manger des huîtres ou voir les stations balnéaires, genre Deauville, Honfleur et tout ça. Faut pas croire qu'il y a que du littoral. La Normandie, ils ont aussi un super terroir. Avec des bons fromages, comme le camembert, tu sais, et des pommes pour le cidre. T'aimes pas le cidre? Essaye le calvados. Après, il y a aussi les plages du débarquement, bien sûr, ou le jardin de Monet à Giverny. Et le Mont Saint-Michel, surtout. Faut que tu le voyes. We did it! Did you understand everything? Ooh, that was tricky. Let's listen to this again without the subtitles and a little bit faster the way I would say it in real life. La Normandie, c'est une région au nord-ouest de la France, au bord de la Manche. Tu peux manger des huîtres ou voir les stations balnéaires, genre Deauville, Honfleur et tout ça. Faut pas croire qu'il y a que du littoral. La Normandie, ils ont aussi un super terroir avec des bons fromages comme le camembert, tu sais, et des pommes pour le cidre. T'aimes pas le cidre? Essaye le calvados. Après, il y a aussi les plages du débarquement, bien sûr, ou le jardin de Monet à Giverny, et le Mont Saint-Michel, surtout. Faut que tu le voyes. Ouh, how did it go? Congratulations, félicitations, you are now a step further into understanding fast spoken French. If you liked part 2 of my series on understanding fast spoken French, check out my next lesson that will be on November 9th, 2021. We're going to talk about everyday slang and explore the region of l'Alsace. In the meantime, if you want to get more practice, check out this playlist that I made for you where I talk more about understanding spoken French. I talk about dropping the N, I explain you how we cut the E and how we cut other letters as well. Just click right here on your screen and I will see you in the next video. Allez, à tout de suite!